The City of Tallahassee is proud to be a leading utility in environmental stewardship. Wakulla Springs is the environmental centerpiece for the Big Bend region, and everyone wants to preserve and protect it. The beauty of Wakulla Springs has captured the human imagination for centuries. Today, Edward Ball Wakulla Springs State Park and its historic lodge are an important regional center for tourism, commerce, and recreation. More than 200,000 people visit Wakulla Springs each year, infusing $22.2 million annually into the local economy. But water quality problems are clouding the future of Wakulla Springs, and scientists now know that the spring's troubles start deep underground and miles away. Wakulla Springs is one of the largest natural springs in the world. It is fed by the Floridan Aquifer. The aquifer is like an underground river that flows beneath much of our state and rises to the surface at our many natural springs. Southern Leon County is a primary recharge area for Wakulla Springs. Rain and other surface waters filter down to the aquifer through porous limestone rock and then flow underground to Wakulla County. As water filters down into the aquifer and flows toward Wakulla Springs, it carries with it excess nitrogen that can be traced all the way back to human activities on the ground surface. Nitrogen is a nutrient for plant growth. When nitrogen levels rise too high in our natural waters, it fuels the growth of unwanted algae. The algae smothers native springs vegetation, allowing nuisance weeds and exotic plants like hydrilla to take over. One source of the excess nitrogen affecting Wakulla Springs was traced to treated wastewater from the City of Tallahassee. Tallahassee uses its treated wastewater to irrigate farmland. While this practice is important for sustaining groundwater levels, the nitrogen content of the treated wastewater needed to be lessened. To address this need, Tallahassee residents invested more than $227 million to upgrade the community's treatment facilities. As a result of Tallahassee's treatment improvements, the nitrogen in its wastewater is lower than the permit level required by the state. But the work is not over to protect the health of Wakulla Springs. Scientists now agree that wastewater from septic tanks throughout Leon and Wakulla counties are the next major source of nitrogen pollution that must be addressed. Septic systems use a tank-like chamber and a drain field to treat wastewater from individual homes. If septic tanks are properly maintained, the discharge won't harm human health, but it can still have too much nitrogen for the health of Wakulla Springs. There are almost 50,000 septic tanks in Leon and Wakulla counties combined. Scientists have pinpointed two critical, mostly rural areas having a major impact on Wakulla Springs' water quality. In both critical zones, the aquifer is covered by only a thin layer of sand. This allows nitrogen-polluted water to flow more quickly into the aquifer and then on to Wakulla Springs. Options to help reduce nitrogen reaching Wakulla Springs from household septic tanks may include upgrading individual septic systems to achieve greater nitrogen reduction or connecting homes to a central sewer system that removes the nitrogen pollution at a central facility. Experts propose tackling the septic tank problems in two phases. First, a program is needed to identify and inspect septic tanks to determine accurate numbers, locations, and conditions. Second, the community will need to develop an affordable plan to better manage wastewater in critical septic tank areas. A nonprofit group or government entity may be created to coordinate the technical and financing needs for this effort. This approach has been successfully used by communities in other areas of the country to tackle similar problems. The decisions we face may not be easy, but the health of Wakulla Springs for generations to come, and the recreation, tourism, and commerce it supports, depend on us.